who would be higher on the list than me to play Ghislaine Maxwell in a miniseries? Name one person who'd be better at it than me.
A better actress?
Or just a better pick.
I don't know.
Maybe like of course, Julianne Moore.
Can you do a British accent? Can you do it?
Of course.
Can you do a British accent? Because it's proper. It's not.
Is it Cockney?
No, that's Cockney. That's Southern.
That was not Cockney. That was nothing.
Southern is Cockney.
You know what I can do?
And then there's Northern, which is Manchester, Liverpool. But Ghislaine, I think, it was sort of slow. It's drone.
It was posh. It was very posh.
It's a deep voice.
Jeffrey, I've got a girl for you.
Oh, it's Naomi Campbell. She's good to see you.
Barely 16.
It's very young. They're very young, but everybody's having fun.
The T's are D's. She's barely 16. You're lovely.
No, now you're going.
I'm auditioning.
Yeah, but it's bad.
You loved this young. I don't know how to say pussy with an English accent.
But Ghislaine would never say that.
Oh, good point.
So you have to understand. You're just being a little naughty, weren't you? Weren't you being a little naughty?
Oh, Jeffrey.
Bill and Hillary were being a little naughty. And it's just kind of a soft.
Billy.
It's a soft, regal kind of British accent. It's not that punchy.
Excuse me. Hold for the boat. We forgot to contextualize that we are on Lake Austin. And there are frats on boats behind us.
It's a softer British partying. Accent. It's not like a Cockney accent where you're imagining it, which is we got all these kids, we fucking the house, love. No, that's not it.
They would have gotten busted way sooner if that was her accent.
Exactly
the
right.
The key to that racket was her in the Escoda and St. John's suits.
Horrible woman, but you got to imagine a great dinner party guest.
Dude, no one can be that damaging and insidious.
And not a little bit of fun.
For that long and not be a charmer. I bet.
Let this episode be an hour defense of Ghislaine Maxwell.
No, but that is that to me is the conversation nobody will have, which is that no one gets away with stuff that long if they're not a little charming or entertaining or beguiling.
Well, it's a hard point to make. I take it and I agree with it.
I think she was the key to his whole racket.
It's a tough. She was. He was a pimp.
Yeah.
She was the person.
But they were like, that's his beautiful wife. He's dating. That is the key to predators, is they're married or aligned with someone that is their same age, even older than them. And you go, well, he's married to her. That's so cool. He's with someone his age.
Right.
Meanwhile, he's getting jerked off by children in, you know, Coconut Grove or wherever.
Right.
So it's like she throws you off because you see that guy at a party and you're like, he's a fucking pervert. And then you're like, wait, he's with her. And
that's true.
She's got some crow's.
That's a very good
She's
point.
Got some crow's feet. She looks like she, you know, has some of those. She doesn't even get her face done. Like, he's not shallow at all. I'm wrong. I'm the
that's
asshole.
That's correct.
I judged him.
Yes, that's
and
correct.
And meanwhile, you know,
and meanwhile,
he's just tearing through.
Quite dastardly activity behind closed doors.
That, to me, is the whole thing.
Well, it's like Bill and Hillary Clinton, right? So you're like, oh, he's with this strong woman who's like a real, you know, she's not a homemaker. She's out there. She's got a career.
Yep.
And he can handle that.
Yep.
And isn't that great? And how modern and how progressive and everything and all the articles in the 90s.
You know what it is?
Yeah.
He wants to date an equal. That's what we say.
That's
he
right.
wants an equal.
And in the 90s, that was the rationale, or that was the whole, the kind of the inertia that moved their campaign forward, was that it was the inevitability of the progressive modern change. This is a strong woman.
Yeah.
And but what it really was partners.
He could be with some thought, and he's
power.
Not.
What was great is that recently there was a quote from the Gail Sheehy biography of Hillary, where after Lewinsky, she didn't talk to him for a matter of months, and then only started talking to him again when she called him and told him to bomb Syria. So that's a real marriage.
So I am fascinated with those old school relationships where it's like, we're a business. And
yes.
I've heard I know a lot of these couples in Hollywood, and the whole thing is, do whatever the fuck you want to do. I don't want to fuck you. You don't want to fuck me.
Right.
We don't have a prenup. Just don't embarrass me. That's the deal.
That's the relationship I'm in with Robert Pattinson right now. It's who wanted a Zoom. He wanted to do a Zoom with me and then backed out of it.
What?
I'm my agent, because Robert Pattinson wants to do a Zoom with you. And then I was like, okay, sure. And then I emailed back, and there was she was like, oh, we'll figure it out, LOL. But then nothing.
Nothing. What do you think? Here's the problem with...
I think it was just, hey, I like your show.
You're in the place where people just want to talk to you.
Yeah,
and you're
maybe.
Like, okay, I'm not going on weird dates. Like, I maybe. Say money and the project up front before I get on the phone with you and waste so much of my time.
I would waste time listening to what he had to say. Why not?
I bet he could help me with my English accent.
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, perhaps. But those, you know, like the Obamas slept in separate beds and the Clintons were like, when you get to that level of work that has to be done every day, you can't have a relationship like my aunt uncle.
This
do.
Is a business. You are both. I used to work on a, I was doing a joke for a while before, when Hillary was running, this was before four. So this must have been, what, 12 years ago? I was in Napa, which is a super conservative part of the country. I didn't really know that. And I went on stage and I said something about like, oh my God, we could have a female president. It's still the chances of her winning at that time were incredibly slight. This is the first time she ran. And I was doing jokes about having a female president. And there were a lot of like kind of unoriginal jokes going around. Like when she's on her period, watch out, she's going to start a war. Like people like had already done shit about female president stuff. But I was trying to do one that was like the first female president, if we have the first female president, we're gonna have to like put in a contract that she's not sucking her husband's dick. Like he has to get sex workers during the time she's president because like no world leader can know she's sucking dick. Like that's the least regal act you can do. Like just everyone needs to know so that they're not sitting in meetings being like, did she have her head in someone's fucking lap last night? Just to let everyone know she's not fucking for that 4 years. It has to be part of it because it's just too degrading. You can't respect someone. And I was in Napa doing a joke in that area and someone yelled at me, know your demographic. And I was like, huh?
Yeah.
And then like, this is the only time I've ever done stand-up where a fight broke out in the audience and I couldn't see what was going on. Like people were like, I just saw like rustling and people, I didn't realize how sort of conservative that area
was. I agree with the person who yelled that. Because it's like, people are trying to get wine drunk in Napa and they don't need you showing up and telling them about Little Miss President.
But it wasn't a charged political joke. It was like I was also talking about Ross Perot. I was talking and I was like, I am just not gonna do political
material.
You're dating
yourself now a little bit. You're like, I was doing my Truman bit. And then I broke into what if we had a lady in there and I got, you know,
not doing a Ross Perot bit, but
my
I did.
Thomas Jefferson chunk. And then I forget you've been in the business literally since the dawn of time. People forget this. About you. This isn't dye. This is her natural hair. She's been in the business so long that she can throw out that she was doing Ross Perot material.
I never was, I swear.
Crazy.
I was trying to think of... No, because then I was like, Dan Quayle. I do so little politics. Growing up and spending most of my time in D.C., you get so fucking sick of politics that I can't even like follow it to me. It's just become a sport.
D.C. is a shitty city because people only...